is Paul. I'm just doing a one-year review on BK7. I've never, the K-Bar BK7. I've never been one for reviewing something straight out of a packet because you haven't tested it yet. I've owned this thing for a year and about 2 months now. I put it through some pretty good tests. I just want to show you what this thing's capable of and what its strengths and weaknesses are. It's mid-range price. Like, I paid $109 for it on Amazon or eBay. Can't remember exactly which one I got it from. One of the strengths I found with this knife is its chopping capability and batoning capability, as I'll show here. I've got me a big piece here.
That's the best I could find.
So, as you can see, no problems with this BK7 for batoning. I baton the crap out of this knife. It takes a beating. Another big strength for the BK7 is its chopping capabilities. I threw this away from the rocks. As you can see, chopping, not a question with this damn thing. It's a beautiful knife for chopping. That's definitely one of its strengths. Now we got the knife tip test. Use the monster. Once again, absolutely no deformation of the blade. This blade is a solid piece of equipment, I'll give it that. The only weakness I find with it is fine, like really fine detail, but that comes with the thickness and the, but even then, feather sticking is really not a problem with it, obviously. And like I said, after a year, between just for the fine details like fine carving and stuff, nothing really wrong. The handle is a little slippery, I'll give it that. But you just gotta get a good grip on it. I might check or pattern the handle to make it a little better. But other than that, BK7, definitely my favorite knife I've had.